put his foot on his mouth. Thomas was down, Thomas. He doubted God. He saw what more food for his birthright. He saw his birthright for a little bowl of lentils. Hannah was teased and she was taunted. Elijah had a pity party. Joseph was sold into slavery. Noah got drunk with his son. She was on her treadmill cycle for 12 long years. Ladies and gentlemen, we already know that if we was on our cycle, that the people in our house would pack up and move to a different continent because they don't want to deal with the emotional crisis that we are going through. They don't want to deal with our moody attitude. They don't want to deal with our wishy-washy ways. So they up and leave. So look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, 2013 issues. Now this woman, she depleted all of her funds by going to various doctors. You see, no one knew the cause of the cycle and why she was flowing so heavy. Nobody knew how to stop the cramps. Nobody knew what to do with the bloating. Nobody knew what to do with her crankiness. She was in a lot of pain. She had back pain. She had stomach pain. She had side pain. But most of all, she was in mental agony. There was no Advil at that time. There was no Motrin at that time. There was no Myalpirs at that time. There was She had been poked on and prodded by the physicians. Most likely she was weak and her iron was very low. She probably didn't smell real good either. Bath and Body Works couldn't cover the stench that she had. I'm pretty sure she probably had some cats following behind her. But I come to tell y'all on tonight that this ain't my issue anymore. This ain't my issue anymore. Now let's look at what the Bible said. It said that she made her way into the town, despite that no one wanted her around. Sometimes we have to go where others may not want us to be, in the place in order for God to get us where we need to be. Sometimes we have to step out of the box, out of the ordinary, so that God can do the extraordinary, so that he can bless you. God has a blessing for you on tonight. That means that sometimes you have to separate yourself from those people that you feel real comfortable with. Sometimes you have to get away all by yourself. We have to go into a place where God can give us direction. We have to go into a place where God can speak to us. It said that this woman got low. She got low. She got low. She crawled her way through the crowd. Not looking at nobody's faces. Ain't want nobody to discourage her. Didn't want nobody to stop her. She said, I'm going to see a king that can heal me of my issues. That can deliver me from this issue of 12 long years. The word says, she touched, I say she touched the hem of his garment. Now the ironic thing about this is, and thousands and thousands of people that was there. And out of all the people, Jesus realized that somebody touched her. He said, who touched me?
Wow.
Who touched me? On tonight, before we go into the next year, Jesus is saying, who touched me?
Yeah.
Who is it? Drop that issue. Who is it gonna be healed from that issue? Who is it that wanna go in 2014 with a new walk, with a new talk, with a new attitude, with a new body that's totally healed? Is it you? Is it you? Is it you? Is it you? Who are you? Your pain. You gotta push past the hurt. You gotta push past the disappointment. Count it all joy. Count it all joy. Say, I might have did what you said I did.